Joining us now is Dr. Robert Murphy. He's a professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Good morning, doctor.
Good morning.
We are talking about the UK variant being the dominant variant. What do we need to know about that moving forward as numbers climb?
Yeah, this was predicted several months ago, you may remember. It took over the United Kingdom first, now the rest of Europe, and now the United States. It's the most dominant. So it's not 100% or anything, but it is the most common variant according to the CDC today, the reports that came out. It's easier to transmit. Maybe that's why some of these numbers are going up. And it is more deadly. So it's got two things going against it.
I think people might be confused why numbers are going up if more people are getting vaccinated every day. You would think that naturally those would just be coming down. What's the disconnect there?
Yeah, well, the disconnect is that we're just shy of 20% of people that are fully vaccinated. And so, Robin, you're right. You know, if that number was 80%, probably we wouldn't be seeing this. So the race is on. Get those vaccines out there so that we don't have a bigger increase. The good news is that the current vaccines that we're using in the United States work against this variant.
Talk about what's going on with that AstraZeneca vaccine.
Yeah, no, this is a saga of, you know, kind of one mistake, a little messiness in the design here and there, and they had problems. But, you know, it's generally a good vaccine. It's cheap, it's easy to transfer, the refrigeration requirements are relatively minimal. You know, there are millions of doses around the world of this thing ready to go. But it looks like about 1 in a million people that get the vaccine get these blood clots, and it doesn't matter the age. Three people under 30 years of age have died from this. And I think the total death rate in the vaccine is 19 people that they suspect have died from the blood clots from the vaccine. So the WHO is calling it plausible, not confirmed, you know, a lot of people are, you know, voting with their feet on this vaccine.
All right, let's take a look at viewer questions. My husband and I have been vaccinated. I received the second Moderna the first week of February, and my husband received the Johnson & Johnson the first week of March. However, we both just tested positive for COVID. We were under the impression that if we get vaccinated, we were safe.
Yeah, this is going to come up. And the way that we measure the effect of the vaccines is typically the prevention of symptomatic disease. So that's with the Johnson & Johnson is somewhere between 67 and 72%. With the Moderna and the Pfizer vaccine, it's like 90 to 95%. So there's a difference. And so no matter what vaccine you get, you can get symptomatic COVID. So this is not that surprising. What you need to remember, though, is that severe disease and hospitalizations and death are basically prevented. So I hope these people have done well and they didn't end up in the hospital.
All right, next question. I have a coworker who wasn't feeling well last week. We went out for drinks and pizza Saturday night with a few other coworkers. He tested positive for COVID on Sunday. The other coworkers got tested Monday morning, were negative, and all came back to work. Shouldn't they have waited a few days to get tested?
Yeah, this person is definitely reading the CDC guidelines. After you have what's called a high-risk exposure, some 15 minutes with another person who's, you know, they're at a bar, they're at a restaurant, and they don't have masks on. So these are high-risk exposures. If you don't have any testing available, it's 10 days of quarantine. If you have a testing available, it's 7 days of quarantine, but the test has to be done at day 5 or later. These people went back to work too early.
All right, here's the next question. My son is 21 with a severe allergy to peanuts and tree nuts. He's never gone into anaphylaxis from it. Do you know if he can get a vaccine shot? Is there any data yet as to which shot might be better for people with allergies?
Yeah, so these people that have the allergies to peanuts and other products and stuff like that, you know, they may be at slightly higher risk for anaphylaxis, but the vaccines are made of something completely different from what these allergies typically are. So anyone with these kind of allergies, you know, should bring their EpiPen. They should have the vaccine done in a place that has the ability to treat somebody in anaphylaxis, like a hospital or a clinic or someplace where there's a big Chicago ambulance or Cook County ambulance sitting outside the door, like where my daughter had at Wilbur Wright College. There hasn't been a big problem. It is okay to take the vaccine. You just have to be a little more cautious and tell the people giving you the shots your allergy history.
All right. If you have a question for Dr. Murphy, you can go to our Morning News Facebook page and post it there. We'll talk to him again tomorrow. Thanks, doctor. Have a good day.
All righty.
Thanks, doctor.
Hey, Paul. Hey.